Hello friends, welcome back to your UPSC. Today we are going to start with a new concept of human geography, that is the concept of regional synthesis. So let's get started. So basically, regional synthesis, as the name suggests, it is dealing with spatial integration or spatial synthesis or spatial interconnection. Okay, so regional synthesis, first we will try to find out the meaning of synthesis. Synthesis simply means to make a complex whole from a number of units. Okay, so when number of parts are unified, then we make a complex whole. And this formation of complex whole, this process of formation of complex whole is known as synthesis. Okay, now regional synthesis, it simply means a science that interconnects the series of concepts and conceptual schemes that have developed as a result of experimentation and observation. Okay, so it actually tries to synthesize or augment various concepts or conceptual schemes, okay, which are developed by experimentation process or observational process. So whatever schemes that we have developed by the experimentation or by observation, they are augmented or they are interconnected, and this interconnection is known as regional synthesis. Now from geographical point of view, if we see, then regional synthesis simply is a concept of spatial integration. That means integrating the spaces, okay, and processes. Spatial integration and processes, which deals with spatial arrangement, distribution, spatial integration, interaction, and organization. Okay, so it actually deals with spatial arrangement, spatial distribution, spatial integration, spatial interaction, and spatial organization. Okay, now if we take a look at the concept of regional synthesis, looking back to its history, we will see that this concept started with Isard, who actually considered region as a study of regional science. Okay, so region was considered as a part of study of regional sciences. Then we had Philbrick, who gave the fundamental classification of region. Okay, so he basically demarcated region on their functional characteristics. Thus, he gave the functional classification of region. Sorry, not fundamental classification, it's functional classification of region. So here he demarcated regions according to their functional characteristics. Okay, then we had Ullmann. Ullmann, he actually propounded the concept of dichotomy and dualism. This concept we will study in the next lecture. Then we had James Connett. James Connett, he actually laid down regional synthesis as a subject of science. Okay, he actually declared or he laid down that regional synthesis was a subject of science. Okay, but if we look at the most important contribution in the concept of regional synthesis, then we will see that the main proponent of the concept of regional synthesis was Berry. He actually introduced an important aspect in the field of regional science, and this aspect was temporal aspect. That means the aspect of time. According to him, if we are studying the spatial, or we are doing any spatial analysis or spatial study, then the aspect of time cannot be ignored. For study of region, the study of region on the basis of its time, okay, is very important, and this temporal aspect cannot be ignored. Okay, now he introduced, we can simply say that he introduced temporal aspect in the concept of spatial analysis. Okay, now what is the concept of spatial analysis? So first we will understand the concept of spatial analysis. Then after adding the concept of temporal aspect, we will understand the whole concept of regional synthesis. Okay. So spatial analysis, we can understand it simply by this diagram. See, this is a flow chart. Okay. Here we are representing regions, and here we have characteristics of the regions. Okay. So here we can say physical characteristics, then we can say climatic, physical, okay, then economic, etc., etc. So these are the characteristics and these are the different regions. Okay. Now if you look at this flow chart from the row, across the rows, we will see that here we have spatial covariation. Okay. So here within a same region, we are studying different characteristics of different of a same region. Okay. So in a same region, we are trying to study different characteristics. Okay. So across the rows, we will see that we have spatial covariation, which is related to systematic geography. Okay. So here we study the fundamental pattern and associated characteristics. Okay. So fundamental pattern and associated characteristics are studied here. Now how they are studied? By limited range of functionally interrelated variables spread over a wide range of different places. So we have a limited range of functionally interrelated variables that are spread over the wide range of different places. So across the rows, we are doing this study of the fundamental pattern and their associated characteristics. Now if we look at across the columns, so this is one column, this is second column. So this is the column of region A and this is the column of region B. Okay. So here we have different columns. Okay. So across the columns, we will study the concept of, or we will have areal differentiation because the area is changing. Okay. So here is region A and here is region B. So area is changing. So across the columns, we will have areal differentiation. So here the geographical, across the column, we have spatial analysis, which is related to geographical analysis, which stresses on the study of local inventionaries and areal differentiation. Okay. So here we have areal differentiation. Now, if we cross or intersect rows with columns, we will see that we have one unit where the row and column, one row and one column, they are intersecting. So this area or this portion, let's consider this portion. This portion is known as cell. Okay. Cell, we can simply define cell as a singular unit. It is a singular unit where we have similar geographical setup. Okay. Here we will have similar geographical setup. Now, what Berry did, this was spatial analysis. Now he said that if we have to study any region or we have to look into spatial analysis of any region, we can't ignore the temporal aspect. Okay. That means for spatial analysis of a region at a particular time, the study of a region at a particular time is not enough. Okay. We have to go back in the past and we have to study the development of that region for having a complete knowledge of that region. Okay. So he actually introduced the concept of time in spatial analysis. So here we were looking for evolution of the region over a given period of time. So let us take this cell. At time 1, let us consider 100 years back, this area was less developed, okay? It was not having any cultural setup. Then 50 years back, this region started to develop. Here we had industries were set up, okay, and various houses were set up. So we can see the cultural development in this region. And at the present time, we will see that this area, this region has developed into a city, okay? So this is the complete study of a region. That means we can look at its spatial aspect as well as its temporal aspects. So Berry actually focused on the understanding of the spatio-temporal aspect of the region for its complete understanding. So this was the concept of regional synthesis, okay? But recently, if you look at the progress of the idea of regional synthesis, we will see that the progress has received a serious setback because of persisting dilemmas in geography. Now, the few of these dilemmas are, first one is, we have persisting tension between the analytical and narrative technique of geographical analysis. Like some of the concepts, they are analytical in nature and others are narrative, okay? Like we had the concept of areal differentiation that was narrative in nature, and the concept of regional synthesis is analytical in nature, okay? So there is persisting tension between both of these techniques in geography or in the explanation of geography or geographical analysis. The next is absence of attention of academics to the new trends of areal differentiation. Now, areal differentiation is having new trends, but the academicians, they are not focusing or they are not giving any attention to this new trends, because of which the whole concept is dying out. Now, the last analysis is, last dilemma is, due to overlapping of regions, we are having difficulty for precise demarcation of the region, okay? So the regions, they are not, or we are not able to precisely demarcate the regions, okay? So these are the three basic dilemmas which we are facing in the concept of regional synthesis. So that was the concept of regional synthesis. So that was all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's lecture. Let's meet in our next class. Till then, take care and have a nice day. Thank you.